Hi, I'm Steve, and I thought I'd go over some ways to stop the static electricity buildup in the dust collection system. There's articles saying that this could be a danger of causing a spark, which could set fire to your shop or worse, your whole house. I kind of wonder how often does it happen, because you know, has there really been examples of this happening? And I really didn't find much as far as that, but one article did say for home shops it just wasn't really necessary, that it was mostly industrial type, you know, big, you know, commercial shops. But then who wants to risk a fire or something like that when it doesn't really cost that much to do something to keep the static electricity down? So a lot of people run the wires around the outside, spiraled around the outside of the pipes. So I did that, and I used to use electric fence wire because it's pretty cheap. And then I decided to go ahead and do a bit more on my longer runs along the ceiling with the PVC sewer pipe, the 4-inch stuff. And I used aluminum tape and ran that along the inside of the pipe, which is where the static electricity would be. Because how much good is it to wrap the wire on the outside of the pipe when the PVC is an insulator? I don't know. So I just thought the tape on run along the inside would be the best way to go. And then what I did was I looped the tape around the inside of the pipe, and then on the ends I looped it around the bottom, and the same thing on the connectors, you know, looped around. So when I connected them up, they just all attach electrically. I tested it out with the ohm meter to make sure each one was connecting, and hooked it up that way. So I'll show you some close-ups of that. It's pretty simple and worked good for me. But one thing I did was, since I'd already had this in use, there was, you know, sawdust already built up in the pipes, real thin, fine layer, and I was afraid the tape wouldn't stick very well. So I kind of took them apart, because I didn't glue the bigger runs, so in case there was a clog I could take them apart. And on the long 10-foot sections, I kind of put a towel in there with some heavy lead shot on the top and kind of just pushed it through. I tilted it up and it just ran through and cleaned all the dust out of the inside of the pipe. Then once I put the tape in there, I used a string to peel off the backing out of the whole 10-foot with one end, you know, connected, so the tape itself didn't move. And then I just did the same thing with the lead shot bag and ran it through several times to kind of help push the tape down onto the PVC pipe, because you don't want that coming loose. That's another bad thing about some people run a wire along the inside of the pipe, but then you're risking clogs, especially with jointer or planer shavings, which can be longer shavings. You can really probably get clogged up easily in a wire on the inside of the pipe. So let me show you real quickly some of the close-ups of what I did. The flexible tubing, which I use near each machine. I also have the wire from the flexible tubing connected to the clamps, which is connected to the wire and the aluminum tape. I also went ahead and connected the flexible pipes. The wire on the inside, I stripped off the plastic and connected it to the clamps and to the aluminum tape also. So those are all done. And then I have a separator, one of those theme separators, which you can probably find how to build one of those. And it's inside of a trash can. On the inside of the trash can, I have a strip of that tape, of the aluminum tape, all along the inside where the stuff swirls around. And then I just put a bolt through that. So the bolt head is on the inside, and the nut and that extra part of the bolt stick on the outside. And a little alligator clip I just hook up to that, and it connects it all to the grounded system.
Here's an example of the aluminum tape coming out of the long piece on the top, and then another piece on the bottom of that connector, the 90 degree that goes down the wall. So that goes all along the inside of the pipe. I still have the wire wrapped around the spiral of the pipe, just because that's what I had there before. I didn't remove that. So the wire on the inside of the flexible pipe I have out here and going underneath this pipe clamp wire, so, and then that's connected to this wire going on the spiral on the outside too. When I have a connection like this with the flexible pipe and then connecting to the PVC, I have the aluminum tape, and I have this red wire goes underneath the flexible pipe, so it's touching on the metal tape, and then over here it goes underneath the clamp, so it's touching there, and then probably on the back this wire from inside here is probably, I'm sure I have it underneath this clamp too, because I took off the plastic from the wire for a little bit and bent it and stuck it underneath this. So everything is a connection to be grounded.
Here's a roll of the aluminum tape that I used. I'll put a link down below so you can see what that is on Amazon. That's it for today. So hopefully this will help somebody out if they want to use the anti-static stuff on their dust collection system, which should hopefully give you some peace of mind that the static electricity won't build up and start a fire. Click like if you liked it, and subscribe if you want to see some of my videos in the future. Thanks a lot.